Hey guys, how's it going? I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer any and all questions you may have. Today we'll be talking about what if piranhas doubled in size. Now, unlike a lot of these movies where piranhas are seen eating and killing humans, that's very rarely the case. In fact, it's unclear if piranhas have ever been held responsible for killing a human. There was one time some believed piranhas killed a young woman, which we'll cover later in this video, yet her cause of death was never actually confirmed. Before we jump into it, make sure you are subscribed, click that bell notification, and drop us a comment down below with another question you'd like answered. For now, let's just dive right into it and see what would happen if these suckers doubled in size. For starters, we gotta talk about how big piranhas currently are. Depending on the species of piranha, they can be as small as 5 inches, with the largest ones, red-bellied piranhas, reaching lengths of 20 inches or just under 2 feet. So if they were to double in size, the biggest piranha we'd find would be about 40 inches or 3 feet 4 inches in length. Although that's still not insanely large, it would definitely have an impact on marine life. Piranhas live in South America's rivers and lakes, with up to 20 different species being found in the Amazon River alone. But unlike popular belief, not all piranhas are blood hungry. In fact, some are actually vegetarians. They travel in packs, more specifically called shoal, and contrary to popular belief, most likely do so to fend off any potential predators. Although it is plausible that they could all gang up on a single predator with other shoals to defend themselves, it's unlikely they would be the initial attacker. Again, these are more specific to the piranhas that feed on the likes of shrimp, worms, carrion, and other smaller fish. There are also the species that only eat river weeds or algae, for example. Due to the fact that they're small in nature, they never go after large fish or animals unless they are already dead or injured to the point they can't fend for themselves. They're also known to have razor-sharp teeth, which work similar to scissors to cut up their food. Now, if these things were to reach double their current max size, what would that mean for the marine life in South America? Well, not too much would change. Aside from their eating habits, it doesn't seem like much else would change. There's the possibility that piranhas would go from eating shrimp and worms to the likes of the tambaqui fish, which is about 3 feet and up to 100 pounds, or the toucanair peacock bass, which is about 3.3 feet in length and 26 pounds average. But to say they would go after the likes of stingrays or armored catfish would be extremely unlikely. However, there is a possibility. These little guys are known to be aggressive in nature, and if they were to double in size, maybe this aggressive nature would give them more confidence in going after much larger fish as a pack, leading to a feeding frenzy. It's no secret their size is one of their biggest downfalls, which is why the likes of dolphins, alligators, and birds feed on them so often. Locals are also known to eat piranhas due to their rich source of omegas 3 and 6. So if they were to double in size, well, it might make them less valuable to the fish market because they'd come in large sizes. Then again, there's also the possibility that they could be worth more money because you'd get double what you do now. So there is the possibility their price could double, going by that standard. When it comes to attacks on humans, much like larger animals, piranhas tend to stay away. There was one case of a 6-year-old girl who was found deceased in Brazil. When her body was found in the water, it was confirmed piranhas had made a meal of her leg. But the cause of death was never confirmed. Some believe she might have drowned before the piranhas found her. Others think maybe the piranhas got her while she was alive and she bled to death. Another case in Bolivia saw an 18-year-old man fatally bitten by piranhas, although that was believed to be a suicide attempt. It's believed he was a fisherman who would have known the dangers of the waters he was found in, and he allegedly purposely jumped out of his canoe, leading to speculation that he planned his own suicide. There have been other cases, such as the 2016 piranha attack in Brazil, which left over 50 people injured within a month. Mostly tourists had chunks of their flesh bitten out of their hands, feet, among other areas, but this was believed to be due to the drought conditions South America was going through, which forced the piranhas to migrate to unfamiliar waters. Although they can smell blood up to 2 miles away, piranhas are also drawn to splashing, which they believe could be a smaller fish in the water. This is why they usually tend to attack younger children, who they may mistake for fish or possible prey. It's believed of the 50 plus that were bitten and attacked, not a single one died. But if the piranhas were to be doubled in size, the fate of some of the younger victims, such as the 4-year-old who had a piece of his heel bitten off, may have been very, very different. Something to keep in mind when piranhas attack, aside from them ganging up on a single unsuspecting victim, is blood loss. If a 3.5-foot piranha attacked a 4-year-old boy, the amount of damage it could cause would be much more serious compared to the bite it would take out of a 25 or 30-year-old man. But again, if the piranha were to take a bite and immediately be hit or swatted away by another person defending this child, the likelihood of the school of piranhas swimming away is actually quite high. They don't like to put up much of a fight, it seems. Rather, they take one bite and depending on the reaction, or lack thereof, they decide whether it's worth it to keep feasting. Usually this is done by one piranha taking the first bite and seeing what happens. Almost like a guinea pig of some sorts. The myth of piranhas being aggressive, killing machines seemed to have started back in the early 1900s, when former President Theodore Roosevelt took a trip to Brazil in 1913. While visiting, he witnessed a group of hungry piranhas devour a sick, aging cow within minutes, leaving nothing but skeletal remains. However, there's much more to the story here. With the knowledge that Roosevelt was going to be visiting the Amazon, local fishermen blocked off up to 300 feet of the Rio Aripuanã with nets to ensure that these piranhas would be starved. Days later, when Roosevelt arrived, locals pushed the sick cow into the river, where piranhas instantly attacked. Due to their lack of food supply, it didn't take long for these little aggressive fish to make a meal out of the cow. Soon, the murky water, which continuously splashed due to the attacking piranhas, turned blood red. Moments later, the skeleton of the cow was pulled from the water, which concluded Roosevelt to believe these fish are one of the most dangerous ever known. Following his trip, Roosevelt wrote a book about his expedition in the Amazon titled Through the Brazilian Wilderness, in which he wrote, I quote, "They are the most ferocious fish in the world. Even the most formidable fish, the sharks or the barracudas, usually attack things smaller than themselves, but the piranhas habitually attack things much larger than themselves," end quote. This led to the widespread belief that piranhas were the most dangerous fish in the world. Not to say they aren't aggressive or something to fear, especially if they were to double in size, it would for sure make them more ferocious. With that being said, it wouldn't be as horrifying as great white sharks doubling in size, which is another video we've done on here that you should check out. But before you do that, let's reply to some comments from the video. What if two hurricanes fused with each other? Jack Harvey said, how long does it take a giraffe to throw up? It's a good question. I don't know. I think when things regurgitate things, they come up faster than they go down, I'm pretty sure. Because it's like a push, right? So even though they have long necks, I would say maybe like 10 seconds. I don't know. How long does it take a human to throw up? Multiply that by like 10. I don't know. Are 10 human necks the length of a giraffe's neck? I gotta look into this one, guys. Hina Kabina said, you guys are just like finding more and more interesting ways for us to all die, huh? Well, I mean, it's gonna happen eventually, so we're just trying to find ways, you know, to make it more fun for you guys, should you want to. King Swag said, you should do a What If 2 series. I need more of you gotta expand more on that idea. Like, I get what you're saying based off of what if two hurricanes fuse together, but like, I don't think what if two sharks merge together would make much sense. So I need more of you gotta explain that more. Like, what other ones would you guys want to see? Let us know in the comments down below. As always, I want to hear your thoughts on this video. Let me know how you guys would feel if piranhas would double in size. Pretty sure they're illegal to have as pets, but would you guys want a 3-foot piranha as a pet? I don't know. It'd be pretty dangerous. Like, if you had a cat or something that went after it, might kill the cat. Anyways, guys, on that note, we're going to wrap this one up. Make sure you give us a thumbs up if you guys enjoyed the video. Subscribe and click that bell to be notified when we post more videos. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein, and we'll see you guys in the next one.